As developers and tech practitioners, you know, we're often tasked with solving complex problems, like automating workflows and building tools that can process and act on vast amounts of data. One challenge that I think we know spans many industries is how to efficiently identify and act on potential opportunities based on that data.
Yeah.
And in this case, let's talk about lead generation. Now, lead generation, as you well know, Brianne,
yeah,
is fundamentally about organizing and managing data, lots and lots of data, right? About customers, about the companies, about the solutions, the products, the trends, the needs,
yeah,
you name it. So this can mean for a lot of teams so much manual, time-consuming work to try to get through all that data, find the synergies, and actually get to value and have actionable insights, right?
Yeah.
So how can we do this better, right? How can we make improvements, make things more efficient and productive for teams? And I think you have at least one answer in the AI world, right?
Yes. So let's talk about, what if you could build an AI agent to help automate the steps you just described?
Yes, please.
All right. So we're going to build an agent and talk about how to build an agent that could continuously monitor this information and all this data. And it can identify potential leads, what lead might be the most successful, generate a couple different versions of things, and really create personalized outreach strategies. And to be able to do this in real time, right? And to iterate in real time and to schedule so we don't forget about things. And AI agents are the core piece of the solution. So really streamlining the process, all of these different steps, allowing faster analysis, optimizing our sales workflows, and helping efficiently do and create content for our customers. So sales teams can gain a lot from using AI agents.
Sounds like it. Yeah. All right. So So how do we get to AI agents?
Yeah.
Take me from what I know in terms of the initial AI to agents.
Yes. So we really started with these fixed flow virtual assistants, we'll call it.
Okay.
So this was a very defined process where, you know, if this, then that type of approach, if A, then B, then C. You know, we had this flow chart and organization of intents and some variability, but largely defined content.
Okay.
Then we moved to AI assistants. And this is where we had the addition of LLMs that entered the picture. And this LLM could add to this fixed flow to be able to answer questions through the most common process was called RAG, retrieval augmented generation. So being able to retrieve information from a knowledge base and generate a response based on that LLM. So really expanding what our virtual assistants could do.
Yep.
Now we have AI agents. And the AI agents build off of that AI assistant. So that LLM is underpinning everything that agent does.
Okay.
And we have three blocks below that. One being tools. So being able to utilize different techniques, common tools that could be shared between agents, being able to control what the agent does.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. In this box. So maybe being going out to pull data, to send an email, all of that's kind of in your tool bucket. Then you have memory. And that is actually being able to save the context of the conversation so that the agent knows exactly what you're referring to. We don't have to save or pull this information. That's all kind of stored and being able to personalize content relative to the agent or conversation. And then we have knowledge. And the knowledge, similar to that RAG piece, is being able to connect to these databases and pull in this information and make it relevant and able for us to take action on. So this AI agents concept really builds on where we started and adds a lot more.
Let's say I do want to build one of those awesome looking AI agents, right? What steps do I actually need to think about? Like, what technical considerations do I need to work in?
Great question, Amanda. So let's dive in, starting with defining our use case.
Okay. Right?
So first, we want to think about what specific kinds of leads we're targeting potentially, if we need the agent to operate autonomously, or if it's going to work alongside a user interface. And next, we want to set the scope. So very important to potentially start very simple, single agent, but we'll want to define, do we want a single agent that handles everything? Do we want multiple agents to work together? Might be one agent for actually data collection, one for analysis, and one for outreach in this example.
Okay.
And one thing to think about with our scope is reusability. So if we have an agent that is potentially going to do all this data collection and doing some analysis, we might want to reuse that agent for something else.
100%. Yep.
All right. And next, we have framework and tools. So very important piece of the puzzle here. But agents could actually be built in Python. They could be built using React or other technology stacks. But we want to select different AI frameworks or libraries that fit our development environment and also our development skills. So we might want to use low-code platforms, or we want to use fully customizable frameworks for more advanced capabilities.
Okay, so what would that look like? Like, let's say,
You know, I have that and want to use that. Like, what are some of these?
Yeah, let's talk through a couple different examples. And all these examples that I'm providing here today are going to be open source, but we'll take into consideration different technical skills, take into consideration what are your short-term and long-term requirements.
Yep.
You want to consider things like complexity, your data, the data privacy, the security, how easy the framework is to use, some of the different integration capabilities and performance. And the frameworks, like we talked about, are really a mix of that no-code, low-code, and high-code tools. So let's dive in. I'll give you a couple examples of where you might want to get started. And by the way, IBM Technology Channel has some great videos on this concept.
They do.
So I'm imagining a little bubble might show up above my head of some related videos that are really helpful that can dive into each of these in more depth than we're going to cover here today.
100%. I know they help me.
Yes. So one of the most simple and most popular frameworks is LangChain to start out with. So this is a really simple agent workflow, modular flow, has support for vector databases and the ability to retain history or memory, which we talked about is so important.
Yeah.
Next, we have LangGraph, which is really part of that same family, but talking about that graph architecture for complex, nonlinear, multi-agent versus maybe a single agent use case workflows.
Okay.
That's where that you know, scope is very important here and comes into play. Next, we have Crew AI, another popular open source framework. It's great for RAG tools. It supports connections to different various LLMs. And then one more example is Llama Index. So an extension of that Llama family. It's an open source framework. Different steps are actions. It has event triggering steps and can save context and memory. And it works well for specific use cases, which might be involving loops.
Okay.
So many other frameworks out there, but some very popular ones to really help you get started. And you can select one of these to build your agent.
Okay. All right.
So
there we go. I'm ready.
All right.
Ready for it. What's next?
So next is data integration. So very important to identify the different systems and APIs that our agent is going to connect with. So this might be, for our example, CRM systems, different email platforms of choice, or external data sources for actually enriching our lead information and the content we're going to generate. We really want to make sure that our agent can process data in real time or on a scheduled basis, depending on our requirements. So something to really think about in how we're collecting that data.
Okay.
And finally, we have the AI models, right? So we're going to want to select the LLM models that are going to be used by our agent. This could be
pre-trained generative AI models or LLMs to really help process and summarize our data and generate content, mm-hmm. or even analyzing patterns mm-hmm. in the lead behavior. And we might need to fine-tune the models. Okay. So we could take a model, yep. fine-tune it, and make sure it's most relevant to our specific use case.
Okay. All right.
And after we've done all that, yeah, we're ready to do the fun stuff. We're ready to build and test the agent. So we're going to integrate the agent with our selected tools and different frameworks. And I don't want to forget about adding guardrails around our whole solution.
100%. So
make sure that we've really defined that scope and we're keeping the agent to exactly what we defined it for.
Definitely testing.
Yes. Before we put it into production.
Brianne, can you give me an example of how an AI agent for lead generation is actually going to work in practice?
Yeah. Yes, let's do it.
Okay.
So let's talk about a potential workflow, starting with and going back to what we just discussed. So we set our use case, we defined our scope. Let's start out with single agent and with more of a LangChain type framework.
Okay.
Very simple to get started. And we'll start off with that data collection and defining what that data collection means. So we might want to take information from places like a CRM system where we can pull the customer information. And where else would you want to get information to maybe generate fine email?
Probably like websites.
Yeah.
Research on products, research on competitors, other databases that we have that have information on, previous contacts or the solutions that they've used in the past, maybe the needs that they have. Yeah.
Awesome. So we'll have data enrichment from different sources like our CRM system, our web pages, all of these serving as our knowledge bases. And then we'll need to think about different tools. So tools that might be reusable next. So that could come in and be things like maybe we already have a tool that connects to CRM system and pulls information about a select customer. That connection's already built. And then we also might need to do some things, right? So what types of doing tools would you want to do for the
tools.
System?
Summarizing
data,
because there's obviously a lot out there. So having that summarization, having analysis, especially calling out sort of synergies or patterns that, are usable that we can act on. Other actionable things might be like generating content, making recommendations for what, to put in an email to an agent. And then honestly, even the follow-up of doing, sending it and having almost like alerts or information on what actions that they take that can feed back into the data.
Great. Perfect. So we're going to take all these things. We're going to gather our data. Then we might use that data, summarize it, analyze it as different tools. And then we're going to generate an email.
Okay.
And we're going to send that out.
Okay.
Now, what LLM do you want to use? So next, we're going to choose our LLM. This is important. You might not know when you start. I'd imagine you want to test out a few LLMs to figure out which LLM works best for your use case. And you might even want to use different ones for different tools that you're going to call within your agent.
Okay.
And then we're actually gonna take that action, pull that into our tools, and then actually generate an email, send it to our client. And we might want to do something like scheduling to actually schedule the send to get some reminders over time on when to send different emails and content so that this whole process is really automating the outreach that's sent. And like you said, maybe some reminders for that seller over time. So
a lot here.
There
right?
is a lot here. It's incredible. I mean, this is great. So, all right. So for example, if I then could set up this agent, and, have it monitor, for instance, postings or like you were saying, alerts and whatnot, then it could, identify
certain components, certain triggers, right? And might even, you know, be able to inform me about solutions.
Yeah.
You know, that I'm building and say, hey, this customer X might want this, and we recommend these outreach strategies. Yeah. Like, is this, am I totally making sense? I mean, I wouldn't have to manually do it. It would just happen.
Yeah, right. So these AI agents, they can learn over time, and they're going to get better at prioritizing these leads, and you'll get feedback in terms of, for example, the types of emails that might be most likely to get selected, or even the system can realize the products that are getting the most attention that might want to be mentioned, or the emails that are getting the most clicks, and can really can recognize the patterns and adapt here.
Great.
Yeah.
So what are some other technical examples of how, you know, these agents can support lead generation? I know you mentioned, you know, you mentioned single agent before, but I know there's more than that.
Yeah. So the really exciting thing is when we design one of these agents, it can be reusable. So we have a single agent here. We maybe chosen to call this our ask sales. Assistant to generate email, or maybe we say this is Ask Sales Gen email assistant. But maybe this assistant has components, or overall, maybe this agent has components that can be used in a multi-agent system. So maybe the marketing team also wants to utilize this, and the marketing team wants to build this multi-agent system that has one agent that actually generates marketing emails to send out to people, but takes into account other agents, like maybe a design agent that works on user design experiences, or other types of skills to pull information truly together in one place. And we also have a concept called headless agents, in addition to the multi-agent concept, where that headless agent, all of this potentially can take place behind the scenes. So you may not be interacting with, for example, a chat interface like you would have been with an assistant or optionally an agent. All of this happens behind the scenes, and then your customer just gets an email.
Wow. All right. This opens up a lot of possibilities.
Yes.
It's definitely streamlining some really time-consuming and manual processes. And, you know, because these agents are autonomous and you have this automation, it'll certainly save time and allow us to focus on more of that, like, high strategy aspects of building robust systems and making sure that the solutions we have are really as robust as possible. So that's great.
Yes. Yeah. So AI agents are a really powerful tool for both developers and tech practitioners who want to move behind this manual workflow and truly build intelligent systems that can adapt and improve over time. Whether you're automating data collection, creating personalized outreach, or integrating with existing tools, AI agents can truly help you solve complex challenges in the sales and lead time generation space.